I'm Michaela Moore, and this is Caitlin Bell. As president and vice president of this class, we can tell you firsthand how long of a road it's been to finally be standing proudly where we are today. And it's truly an honor to have all of you here with us. All of the support you have shown us has brought us our successes, and we are here tonight to celebrate our accomplishments. Would you please rise as members of Free Design perform the Star Spangled Banner?
Possible. Later, the names of our graduates are going to be called out by Caitlin Bell and Michaela Moore, your hostesses for this evening. Seven of their classmates have been selected or have earned the right to represent them at graduation. The collected ideas that you will hear tonight represent the full spectrum of the North Valley graduating class. Please welcome to the stage our first student speaker, Mr. Matt Fairman.
I wish we could get this many people in here for basketball games. All right. So I would once again like to welcome you all to the graduation of the class of 2015. And I must also thank you for being here, especially all the parents that are willing to sit here for a couple of hours to watch your child go up on a stage for maybe a minute to get handed a piece of paper. So, for those of you who don't know me, I am Matthew Fairman, and I moved here on my sophomore year from Hawaii. So, I left my tropical paradise home to come to Grants Pass, Oregon. And that's how I felt. I was a bit negative about everything, but then, you know, I came here, and my friend Chris, he invited me over to the table with all his friends, and I met people, great people, and connected, got involved in sports and everything, and North Valley became a great place because of the people in this class. And so with confidence, I can say that because of my classmates, Grants Pass has become a home better for me than Hawaii ever was. I still miss the beach though. So there will be, like you said, there will be a number of other students speaking today. They'll be here because of their outstanding school performance and recognition as valedictorians and salutatorians. The reason I'm speaking today, along with my friend Trinidad, is because we're just good pals with Meisner. And so, because of that relationship, a door was open to us, and that's what life is about. It's about making connections and seizing the opportunities that it creates. No, I'm kidding. I mean, it might be true. I don't know. I'm an 18-year-old kid. I'm just graduating high school. So I'm not going to stand up here and try to impart some sage advice to everyone. I'm just going to, I'll leave that for the valedictorians and salutatorians. But I will tell you about my day yesterday. So, yesterday, me and the whole class, we went on the Hellgate jetboat excursions. That's the thing with, and the boats, they take you up and down the river. We ate together for maybe the last time. But no, everyone had a great time. And at one point on the trip, we were speeding through this canyon, this river part, and there were rocks on both sides. And we didn't have much room to slow down. Me and my friends were sitting in the front. And we see these little objects going across the river. We're like, what is that? And it was these 7 or 8 little ducklings. And the boat didn't have anywhere to veer to the side. And so we just plowed right on ahead. And you know, everyone, like kids, some people were laughing, other kids were like about to cry. And it's like, oh God! And so, but then afterwards, they see like some of them, I think most of them, they were fine. They got back up and kept swimming. And I think all of them did, hopefully. Those of them that didn't. But anyway, these ducklings were heading out into the world for adventure or whatever. Maybe they're going to duck school. Anyway, just like all us seniors are now, we're going out into life. We're coming out from under our parents' wings and heading out into the world where we'll learn awesome things like how to collect debt and that eating top ramen for the next 4 years of our life isn't as great as it sounds. And the world might hit us with a few jet boats, you know? Bring out there. But we just gotta take the hit and get back up and keep swimming like those ducklings. So that was my best day yesterday and everything I have to say about it. And so I'd just like to say congratulations to myself and 2/3 of my class that are here today. Now, if everyone would please stand and welcome our first salutatorian speaker, Michaela Moore.
I would like to take a moment and thank all of you for coming, especially to our parents who helped us get here today. We couldn't have done it without you. I thought of all the metaphorical comparisons I could make, but finding something that related to everyone was way too hard. So I stuck to something I knew, sports. No one likes to lose. Ask any athlete. All of them dream of making a buzzer beater or hitting a game-winning shot or even scoring the winning touchdown. It's something they played over and over in their heads for years. And when it happens, people talk about it for weeks and sometimes months. People, whether it's fans, players, or parents, love to win. Victories are moments that stay with us forever, like the first day of kindergarten. We clung to our parents' legs, terrified by the idea of being left behind with complete strangers. But when they finally managed to pry us off and left us alone in a room with 20 other kids in the same boat, our mutual feelings of sadness and abandonment led to a lifetime of laughter, joy, and friendships. That first day of kindergarten marked our first steps towards the finish line, our first big moment of overcoming, our initial steps into a school system that by our senior year, we couldn't wait to escape. By freshman year, we realized life wasn't all finger painting and nap time, although we wished it was. We each had our own little victories, whether it was in math league, sports, free design, or a list of others. We jumped at any opportunity to be involved and thought life couldn't get any better. But we also faced adversity. For the first time in our lives, we learned that mom couldn't fix everything. Classes became harder, we had to get jobs, and balancing school plus a social life seemed almost impossible, I know. The state championships, Headley games won, mapping competitions, and tests that we aced were all great. But besides the joy of winning, were these victories stuff that would really teach us lessons that would last? Yes, all these little victories got us here today, each one equally important as another. Whether it was making it through kindergarten or passing high school, each of us learned something much more important than succeeding along the way. Winning state was great. But was it really what would better us for life? Or is it the times in practice when running that last suicide felt like it would be the death of you, but in the end taught us how to push past the limits we set for ourselves? Or the hours spent trying to remember a line for the play that you just couldn't seem to remember, but when the pressure of the audience was there, you nailed it without hesitation? Or more importantly, the people who helped us. The teammates that became family, the friends that had our backs no matter what, especially when we needed a highlighter in Mr. Peck's class. And the teachers and coaches who believed in us, even when we didn't quite believe in ourselves. We learn so much more from our defeats than we do from our wins. Unless winning includes acing one of Mr. Peck's tests, then you succeeded on a whole other level and deserve a giant round of applause. Success is what everyone else sees, and yes, it is what we should strive for. But we also need to remember the losses that led to our success. Those pressure moments you dream of don't always work out the way you plan. But getting up and working harder in practice the next day, that's what makes us better. That's where we show what we are made of, not just as actresses, athletes, or students, but as people. You see, in our struggles is where we grow. The ability to face adversity and overcome it, that's what winning is. 10 years from now, we won't remember the games we won or the tests we failed, but we will remember the feeling after. The feeling of defeat and not wanting to feel that way again. We'll remember how we reacted to the loss. The extra studying, staying late at practice, singing in front of the mirrors for hours. That's what will get us far in life. The ability to fall and persevere, to get up again and again, and to work harder for the next challenge that we face. In reality, high school hardships are nothing compared to the difficulties that will come in life. However, high school did teach us how to deal with the struggles and ultimately overcome even the largest of them. So, class of 2015, As we embark on our next race, remember our friendships, hold on to our victories, and let us learn from our struggles. Remember how much it hurt to lose and hold on to the joy of winning. But most of all, don't let the fear of striking out keep you from playing the game. Failure is a part of life, but it's only a step on the way to victory. And we never know what's waiting for us at our next at-bat. After all, a home run could be waiting just over the bend. It's my pleasure to introduce our next SLU historian speaker, Kestrel Ray. Tonight is our last night as NV students. Tonight is the night to look forward to the rest of our lives. But I also want to look back at all that we faced. One of the things that has distinguished our class more than anything else is that we are the class that everything is tested on. Or, as Mrs. Turner might prefer, the CUI class, the guinea pig class. During our first year here at North Valley, our trials began. From our very first day, the first experiment began with science inquiry and freshman form. As we all know, we were the first and last class to sit through those particular classes. Sophomore year, the enrichment or intervention schedule was introduced, though not in the form it has today. It originally involved a complicated change of classes, leaving us disoriented and confused, to the point that we didn't even know when we could finally leave and return home. This schedule changed, and changed again, and then finally, it changed again. Luckily, this year we got to keep the same intervention schedule for the entire year. The only other class that has been through all the intervention ups and downs is the junior class, who after tonight will be the senior class.
Yeah, baby!
Following our intervention adventures, we had our final test as of the CUI class. Last year, we had a great time field testing the Smarter Balance test. All of you know how that turned out. Junior almost seniors, we leave the rest of the Smarter Balance fun to you. But our class experiences weren't all bad. We had a lot of fun firsts as well. Some of us were sorted into houses the first time that Mr. Starkey entered his classroom into Hogwarts. We've had many, many new teachers, but we've gotten to keep many of the same teachers throughout high school. We've seen drama productions change from teacher-directed to student-directed. A few of us were on the first North Valley tennis team. We saw the boys' basketball team make it to state not once, not twice, but three times. We learned a lot here in high school. And what we learned wasn't just from our old textbooks, but from all the new things. There are a lot of changes in life, and we've been well prepared to face them after this. So I want to say thank you. Thank you to the teachers who've made us stay up late to meet deadlines. Thank you to the principal who's tried to make us strive to get B's or better and 92% attendance. Thank you to the parents who've listened to us rant. Thank you to the school board that has changed our schedule so many times for keeping us on our toes. And thank you to you guys, my classmates, for standing with me through it all. We've had a great time being the CUI class. Now please welcome valedictorian speaker Cassie Logan.
Or just have never heard my voice before, I'm Cassie Logan. And that alone, that a lot of you don't know me, proves that getting good grades alone isn't the most important thing in high school. Learning not just material, but how to actually talk to peers and when to take risks will help far more than knowing the Pythagorean theorem or what an adverb is for every moment past now. 3.3 million people are graduating high school this year. Our diplomas aren't that special. We haven't done anything other than our designated job up to this point. Take the skills you learned and apply them in a way that the letter A could never be used. fix broken cars, treat sick people, discover something awesome. So when your kids ask about your high school experience, you won't be telling them about the girl that wasted her time at graduation. You'll be telling them how our class had the most lunch detentions Fleming had ever seen in 1 year. That we are the smallest graduating class ever in North Valley. That we were the last class privileged with Mrs. Davey for years, or to have Mr. Delders as an 8th grade English teacher. We've been the absolute best at being the worst. But it was pretty great. Many of us have bonded with teachers and staff that will never forget us either. And for all of that, I thank you. It is my pleasure to introduce valedictorian speaker, Jordan Gillespie.
For the class of 2015. First, I would like to congratulate all of my fellow graduates for finally reaching this day. So I was sitting in my room trying to figure out what I would write my speech about, and after millions, and maybe a million more drafts, I decided to share with you the story of several remarkable individuals who had a rocky start in life but still came out on top because they chose to succeed. I decided to start with the story of an American president to show my patriotism for America. Abe Lincoln was a man who failed in business at the age of 21, experienced the death of his lover, had a nervous breakdown at age 27, and was defeated in 8 elections. And yet, he became the 16th president of the United States. Albert Einstein didn't speak until the age of 4, did not read until the age of 7. And he was regarded as being mentally slow, unconscious, and adrift forever in foolish dreams. But against all expectations, in 1921, he won the Nobel Prize in Physics. Walt Disney also faced many setbacks in his career. He was fired from a newspaper because he was said to lack imagination and original ideas. Later, his concept of Disneyland was rejected by the city of Anaheim, and he was bankrupt several times. While they said he had no talent, Walt Disney became one of the biggest creators on Earth. Before reaching the top of the billboards, the Beatles were turned down by a recording company that said, "We don't like their sound, and their guitar music is on the way out." Now, I bet those recording executives are crying on any shoulders right now. So, why am I telling you all of these stories? Well, these days, everyone is asking us what we are going to do with our lives. As I see it, we have two choices. We can choose to survive only to get by, or we can choose to succeed. So, my fellow graduates, future educators, lawyers, artists, parents, we hold the destiny of our country in our hands for now. Let's choose to flourish and to succeed. Now, I know this isn't the Oscars, but there are some people here today that we should all thank. First, I want to thank my teachers for putting up with me, my antics, and my annoying voice, and how I never stop talking in class all the time. I'm sorry, Mrs. Turner, personally. My parents for driving me around until I got my license at the beginning of my junior year. 2 years of sports and school, just they didn't have a good time. They came to all my events too. And then my friends for editing my AP Lit essays 12 at night on Google Docs for the reason I'm right here. Without any of you, I wouldn't be standing up here today, and my life would be far less beautiful and fruitful than the gift I've been given. Remember, a diamond is merely a lump of coal under pressure, and there is beauty in all of us. Embrace graduation and the change it brings to us. Because change may not be a four-letter word, but too often our reaction to it is. Thank you, North Valley. And now please welcome our next valedictorian speaker, Rochelle Banta.
Love you, beautiful girls. Go, girls. As you heard, my name is Rochelle Banta, and if the last 4 years here taught me anything, it's to be unique and creative. I'd still like to give a quick thank you to all the teachers, mentors, friends, and family who helped me to get to where I am today. So thank you. Ultimately, though, this speech is for my fellow classmates. And as I searched through Wikipedia for inspirational quotes with barely credible sources, I realized something. My job isn't to stand here and motivate you. Everyone has their own reasons to work hard in life, and everyone has their own unique experiences which make up who they are today. Encompassing all of that into one mind-blowing 3-minute speech would be kind of impossible, so instead, hold on, pause. I would like to share a brief story about our time together as a class. This is a story all about how our lives got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute to just listen to me as I come in and graduate class today. Smart A's, reading and writing, learning to be cool, and all playing soccer outside of the school. And over the years, new friends they stood, starting in as your neighborhood. We worked hard 4 years, the closer we'd be to say I'm graduating with the class of 15. So look for a job with the time paid near and the license plate should. Oh, shoot, nah.
Oh.
mic over here for a minute, please.
Hello. That took us 2 days to memorize, so I'm sorry, guys.
Well, what we make up for, what we lack in size, we make up for in character. However, this actually is an academic award ceremony as well. And before we present the class and kind of give them our last bit of challenge, we would like to acknowledge the top performing academic students in the class. So I'm going to ask the following people to please stand and stay standing until we have finished introducing our valedictorians and co-salutatorians. The following people have earned a cumulative grade point average of 3.5 to 3.74. Haley Pershing. Thor Whitmore, 3.5 to 3.74. Tristan Van de Heij, Scott Grunbach, Octavia Wade, Danielle Swantes, and Logan Phillips. The following people have scored between 3.5 and 3.75. Stay standing, please. Haley Pershing. Jamie Diaz. The following people have got a great point average between 3.75 and 4.0. Jamie Diaz. Chris Novak. Emily Allen. Brandon Rogers. Catherine Morrison. Caitlin Bell. Thomas Gibbons, Hope Gazelle, Matthew Merriman, Nicole Lee, Emily Patron, Chris Morsa, and those students who have scored above 4.0, Taylor Mayshore, Gabriella Edwards, Severin Bury, Katie Toledo, and your co-salutatorians, Kestrel Ray, and Michaela Moore, and the co-valedictorians, Rochelle Banta, Cassie Logan, and Jordan Gillespie. Be seated. You get to stand up in a little bit. So before we ask our board members and our superintendent to award our diplomas, we have a last challenge to our class. Members of the class of North Valley 2015, being your principal has been an honor and it has been a challenge. An honor because so many of you have come so far and have overcome so much. You all made the personal effort and choices that make you a graduate. You have blessed me personally with countless two-minute conversations that in some small way have shaped the people that you are today. I am most honored because you have become the quality young people that your loved ones have always believed that you could become. Now, I have been challenged because it took so long for so many of you to meet the final proficiencies so that our teachers could actually give you passing grades. We have come to one of the closing moments of your childhood. Your personal door awaits, and so does the rest of your life. And so, I hope you will take 5 things with you. Courage. Every morning's a new day. Rise to the challenge. Competitiveness. It is going to take your very best most of the days of your life. 3, character. Wherever you go, whatever you do, you take yourself and you take your loved ones. Commitment. Your name is your word. And truly, it's about the only thing you have. And 5, compassion. Love and concern for others goes a long, long way. So thank you for your time with us, and may you find the perfect place that you were born to fulfill. May you prosper in the path that you choose, and may your journey be beautiful, both in its scope and in its purpose. So, Mr. Holmes, Superintendent, and members of the Three Rivers School Board, the students gathered before you have earned their diplomas by meeting the graduation requirements of the Three Rivers School District and the essential skills of the state of Oregon. Let's graduate the class of 2015.
Diego F. Borja.
Amber E. Potter.
Justin.
Aaron L. Hook. Brandon P. Roberts. Cecilia J. Dethridge. Logan A. Phillips. Skylar J. Hyatt. Jordan M. Etchegis. Randall D. Nicholson. Charles O. Draper. Hope E. Gertel. Matthew Jackson. Travis J. Mead. David M. Walker. Richard O. Hicks. Brandon C. Steinel. Samantha M. Nye. Thor A. Whitmore. Matthew R. Witcherly. Kaylee M. Welch. Faith L. Harrington. Kevin G. Olson. Andrew T. Richardson. Christopher C. Novak. Mason K. Bishop. Tyler R. Adair. Jesse Morris. Michaela S. Moore. I'm glad we're the smallest class, that was a lot of names to read. Caitlin M. Bell. please welcome Trinidad Flores to the stage to present our closing remarks.
No, thank you guys. Good evening. I'm Trinidad Flores. From Salvador, I'm also going to see us. I'm going to be performing. And I know I'm going to be from the exit door, so I'll make this quick. First of all, thank you. Thank you, parents, teachers, staff, and Wikipedia, for all you have done to get us where we are today. Please give them a round of applause. Class of 2015. I've had the privilege to be at North Valley for 4 years and see our class grow together. Our freshman year, we did not have a good reputation. But as the years went by, we matured, got multiple, and I mean multiple life lessons. Thank you, Mr. Meisner, and thank you, Ms. Converse. And as I stand before you today, I would like to congratulate you guys for all the amazing achievements that you have all accomplished to make this school a better place. But before I send you away, it's my turn to give you a life lesson. We must not forget that after I finish this speech, we enter the real world. Some of us are leaving the college, others will be joining the workforce. Whatever you decide to do after we leave here, do it good. Do something you love to do. Do something you're passionate about. I believe that every single one of you is great and can do amazing things in this world. Mahatma Gandhi once said, live as if you were to die tomorrow, learn as if you were to live forever. We must live life to the fullest and enjoy the friendships and relationships we have and continue to expand our knowledge, because it's a jungle out there. It's time to take the next step of our lives, and I'm truly excited to see what all of you have and have yet to accomplish. Class of 2015, it is time to show the world what we can accomplish. Will the North Valley High School class of 2015 please stand? To signify the completion of this ceremony and the completion of our time at North Valley High School, together we will move our tassels from the right side to the left side. We made it!
Instead of going to the Merlin exit, please turn right at the bottom of the hill, follow our Monument Drive, and take the Hugo exit and then back into town. Big construction mess down here. Thank you for coming. Best wishes.